of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Cougars. Welcome to SCTV News for Wednesday, May 22nd. I'm Angelie Massey.
And I'm Connor Mangan. Senior interviews continue tomorrow, and we will be back on minimum day schedule. 12th graders need to double-check their senior interview time and room number before they present their website to the judges. Results from the first 2 days of senior interviews are currently being collected and will be released soon.
The Still Canyon yearbook will never be the same after this year. The teacher in charge of the yearbook for nearly 20 years is planning on retiring after this edition. But she is leaving behind an impressive legacy, and Jaden Rojas and Diego Bertolino explain.
If you know Miss Dickinson, you would know that she treats each yearbook like gold.
Miss Dickinson sees each yearbook as like a baby for her. She raises it all year long. She helps the kids who are working on yearbook grow as journalists, and she just doesn't give up.
When you look at creative things or pictures or just doing like portfolio type work and stuff, when it looks excellent, you probably know that Miss Dickinson had a hand in that. And it's going to be a challenge for the newcomer because she is at the top of her game, and it's going to be hard to repeat and do what she has done.
The yearbooks have so much care and importance to them that everyone has a memory that leads to the yearbooks.
The yearbook is a place for us to be able to look back on the year and have a physical reminder of all of those things that made the year special for people.
A yearbook is always fun because it captures like the life of the year, and it captures the opportunity for a lot of the students to be recognized and convey important moments, whether it be academic or even sports or outside activities and things like that.
Not only do the yearbooks hold the memories of Steel Canyon students, but they also hold the memories of Steel Canyon families.
For me, the thing that is really special is Miss Dickinson always makes sure that she has pictures of staff who have students on campus. And for a lot of us, we love this school, and we love it so much that we bring our kids here.
The first yearbook is kind of interesting, even though Miss Dickinson wasn't here at that point in time, just because it only reflected one grade of kids, and so it was all freshmen, and it was just showing sort of the beginnings of what a high school could be without having all the things that a high school would have, like there was no prom yet because we only had freshmen. We only had some sports, not all sports. We had no varsity sports at that point in time. Everything was like freshmen or JV.
Not only do students have their favorite parts in the yearbook, but teachers also have their favorite sections as well.
My favorite part when I look back on the yearbooks, I always like to look at the sports and to see the different kids who are in the sport. They seem like at the time kind of mundane pictures of the team just like, you know, standing up really tall and like all in a row. It seems like those pictures aren't that important, but I love them because it just marks that moment in time.
I coach, so I always like to look at the sports pages and see the athletes in the pictures there.
This may be the end of an era, but Miss Dickinson has stories to be told. So stay tuned for the next episode. Until then, for SCTV News, I'm Diego Bertolino.
There's still time to order Miss Dickinson's last yearbook. The cost is $85, and you can order through our school website. And you won't have long to wait, because the yearbook distribution is coming up next week on Thursday, May 30th.
Sending junkie rhythms right down your block. We beat to rap, what key beat to lock, but I'm cool like that. 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 Cool.
We be the chocolates, tats on my raps. She innovates after sweeter cat naps.
You're running out of time to check out the amazing work at the Grossmont District Student Art Show. The creations are currently on display at the Lakeside Library, and Cougar artists will be well represented, taking home 30 different exhibit runs through this Saturday. So make plans to see everything before they are gone.
Every Wednesday, SCTV News is partnering with the special education teachers and students in room D110 for the weekly weather report. Here's what to expect for the rest of the week.
Good morning, Cougars. My name is Jason with your weekly weather reports. This week will be partly cloudy with temperatures in the 60s. That's your weather reports. Now back to news for our Cougars. Goodbye, get some!
There are some new resources available in the SCHS library, from digital devices to new areas. You're invited to check everything out before the start of the summer. Ms. Helm has a tour.
Hi, broadcast. Welcome to my crib. First things first, we have a bunch of like electronic resources now available for you guys to check out. A big one, we have headphones for use in the library. They're Bluetooth, so they can connect to your phone, to your Chromebook, no matter what phone you have. They're over the ear, super comfortable. Unfortunately, they're only for use in the library, so I can't let you go and take it to your classroom, but all the more reason to come hang out, right? You can use them for schoolwork, you can use them just if you want to come and hang. All is well. We're going to check them out to you, I just need you to return them before you leave. Super fun. We also have an entire new digital library, so we're offering Kindles that you can check out as well. This one's... Ta-da! And you can access all of our ebooks and our audiobooks, which we now have available for you to check out. If you'd like to request any, we have a book request form that I can show you later. And you can ask us to get your new books. Ebooks and audiobooks we're able to get a lot faster than physical books. So if you have something you want to read right away, right now, let us know and we can grab that for you. Ebooks, audiobooks. We also have new power towers around the library for you to charge your devices, your Chromebooks, your phones, whatever you need. So I can show you one of those. They're gonna look like this. And these are gonna be scattered throughout the library. We have three total, one in all of our major areas. We have just regular outlets and also USB ports. So you can plug in all your chargers right over here. We also have Chromebook chargers and phone chargers available to you if you need. While we're over here, another one of our really big additions, we have our craft corner. So exciting. This is great if you want to work on a school project, if you want to do stuff just for fun. We have coloring pages, we have markers, we have colored pencils, we have pens, we have colored construction paper, whatever you could possibly need. We also have a lot of extra stuff available specifically by request at the front desk. We have some fancier art supplies, some Posca pens, some Prismacolor colored pencils. Those we're gonna check out to you. We also have different resources for different crafts. So we have some crochet patterns up here. We also have some origami patterns. Origami paper and yarn and crochet needles are available by request up at the front desk. So if you wanna do that, we got you. But yeah, a whole lot of cute stuff. And then we can find these in our fiction section on all of our shelves. But we have these QR codes right here to request books. These are for physical books, audiobooks, ebooks, whatever resources like you want. If we don't have something and you are like, hey, I wanna read this like right now, we can buy that for you, yeah? So if you're looking for anything specific, go ahead and fill out that request form and we can get that. We have more than 10 magazine subscriptions right now. Some educational, some just for fun, some like just like real life variety magazines, women's health, men health, entrepreneur, the New Yorker, astronomy. So many selections for us to like kind of check out and enjoy. But these are our magazines. Ta-da! So fun, so cool. We're able to print things for students. So if you need to print out any homework assignments, any like extracurriculars, any flyers, we can print those here. We have a black and white printer. And if you want to print that, we have our little sign. You can go ahead and send it to library@schscougars.org and we can print that out for you right here in the library.
Football returns to Cougar Stadium tomorrow night. A team of Cougar seniors takes on the juniors in this year's Powder Puff game. The gates will open at 6 p.m. and the game will start at 6:30. The tickets are just $5 online on the GoFan website, and they will be $10 at the gate. You must bring your student ID with you to enter the game. Also, the class of 26 and 27 will be selling concessions, so bring your money and root for the Cougar juniors and seniors.
You could help save a life this week. Our very own Red Cross Club is hosting our blood drive at Steele this Friday. Students who are at least 17 years old can donate. You can receive a time through our ASB website. Not only will you be helping your community, but donors will receive a $5 Starbucks gift card.
The Cougar softball team is one win away from the CIF championship game. Steel Canyon traveled to Granite Hills yesterday to play the top-seeded Eagles, and it was our girls who came out on top. However, they must win twice to advance.
The next game against Granite is tomorrow afternoon at 3:30, and it's in the back of their field once again. Tickets are still $10 through the GoFans website. If the Cougars can pull out another win, they could go to the CIF Division I title on Friday on the campus of UCSD.
And that's all the news we have for you today. Have a great week. Rah-rah Cougars.
Cougar Pride,
get some.